We had been mainly a corn-soybean rotation with the soybeans following the corn. And since we introduced some cereal back into the cropping rotation, I'll plant the barley or the wheat, and then I'll come in with a cover crop after it's harvested. And then the markets or whatever will kind of dictate that, but I will follow it either with corn or soybeans. And sometimes I will follow maybe with a winter wheat into it too. So. With the cover crops, we've done different things. We've got a demo site that I work with Abby Wick from NDSU on, and we've done a little bit of everything out there, from rye strips, and then rye with radish, turnip, dwarf Essex, different things, and then we planted the soybeans into them to see if there's any response, and because it's a very saline soil there, so we're trying to fight the salt issues there and stuff. We also put some salt alfalfa in patches out there and stuff. So we've really used a broad range of different cover crops. Following the barley last year, I knew I was gonna put corn. We used flax in there and some sunflower and stuff. And the flax was gonna help with get the soil condition, the mycorrhizae ready for the corn crop the following year. Well, there's many benefits in cover crops. We were no-tilling all our soybeans into corn stalks. We've been doing that for quite a few years. I'm trying to reduce my tillage, so we basically are a minimum till, which consists of a Salford, a vertical tillage tool, is what we got it down to now. And there are radishes but particular radish, that's my tillage tool now. They go out, they bust up the hard pan. I feel the soil really likes to have something growing in it all the time. Keeps the soil biology, you know, everything rolling along throughout the whole year. And I got that salinity issue in some of my fields, and it's a way to combat that, get the holes in the ground from the radishes and the turnips and everything, and to get the water to go down, the salts to leach back down. And additional benefits of cover crops too is the erosion factor. You go out there, you till your field in the winter, the snow is here, and you see all that black dirt on top of the white snow. And I've learned after I started working with the soil health team there that our soils are slowly blowing away. So the cover crops really help for erosion. We have said some soils in North Dakota that were 30 some inches, the topsoil is 30 some inches, and they're down into the teens now. So, and I got some areas I got only 6 to 8 inches of topsoil left. So the cover crops are helping manage my erosion, you know, very well. As far as problems go with cover crops, if you got the moisture, they get going right away. We flew some rye on into standing corn a few years ago, and we didn't get any rain, and therefore rye never really made it. This will be probably about my fourth year now that we've been working with the cover crops. We have been planting the cover crops with the same no-till drill. You can really plant cover crops many different ways. Cover crops are pretty new yet, and different ways to implement them. There's people coming up with new ideas all the time. Cover crops are a solution to help the salinity, and slowly, you know, you get bring it back into production. And, you know, even just getting foxtail barley, that grass that naturally likes them areas, just to keep that growing, keep it mowed down so it doesn't go to seed, just to get something growing, and then start introducing cover crop into that, and then slowly work towards getting that saline area back into shape. I wish I would have started using them earlier. It would be the thing when it came to my minimum till, no till. And introducing small grains back into it has allowed me to get uncertain ground, get cover crops in there where I do have my salt issues and different things. And now we're all learning on how to try to get it into a standing crop like soybeans and corn to get something growing that'll be there following spring, so you could, you know, that'll benefit the ground right away, suck up some excess moisture, you know, and if it does get wet, then we can plant green into it, which is looking like it's going to work pretty slick. You can almost plant in the rain doing it sometimes. So spring of the year, where we've come and we're going to plant in, we had some strips that we had left where we had no cover crop. I stuck my handle and my plier in the ground, pulled it up, and it was just a big muck ball on it. I went over where the cover crops were, I stuck it in, pulled it out, and it was just clean, like I just pulled it out of my plier holder. So that's one thing I guess I've noticed. It's a tool to see how your cover crops, what they've done for you in the spring of the year too, you know, using up some excess moisture. And when it comes to cover crops and advice, I would say try them. Try to implement them into your farming system, because it's the soil needs something growing in it at all time. You need all that activity underneath the ground, the worms to the roots to everything involved in the soil health structure of it all. So yeah, if you can work it into your system, it's worth a try.